Krzysztof Penderecki is the first composer that we will perform his music. Known for really avant-garde music, I can think of the Melody for the Victims of Hiroshima, which is, if you've never heard this, you should, especially now in this very tense world situation. However, great composers, in order to hone and perfect their craft, they look back. They look back at the masters. In this first piece, it's three movements in the old style, and he goes neo-baroque, completely back to the masters. So it's quite consonant, not a whole lot of dissonance, at least not on purpose. It takes us back to a time of simpler world. So here are the three movements in the old style.
Thank you.
Right now is definitely decompose the music. So this is what happens on a full day. They've had quite a few rehearsals with me, pretty intense. I wouldn't want to spend 6 hours with me either. This is the first time this morning when they all came together to see this music. And it's a stressful situation, to say the least. We'll see how the rest of the concert goes. We might have to stay behind, so folks, you may need to leave them here so they can practice. I'm going to move on. The next piece is by Astor Piazzolla. It's called Melodia in A. Astor Piazzolla is an Argentinian composer. Worked with Nadia Boulanger in France, in Paris, and then went back to Argentina, his native land, to elevate the tango. In tango used to be sort of the people's music, for lack of a better term. And he elevated it for the stage, added new instruments, saxophones, guitars, and he also played the bandoneon, which is sort of a box, looks like, sounds like an accordion, but it's not exactly an accordion. Great composer. This one is an arrangement for string orchestra that I made quite a few years back. So here is Melodia in A by Astor Piazzolla. And I can, I got my sound in back, surprise. And I can say, I can see the look, the frightened look on their faces. They are going to concentrate from now on.
Thank you.
work of someone who needs no introduction, Johannes Brahms, known for his symphonies, a lot of really great work with his Requiem, wonderful stuff. But he also enjoyed going into the different countries, especially Hungary, and picking up some of the music from that country. So here's the very popular Hungarian dance number 5 in G. Today. it really compels them to draw on any sort of pain or anything that they've had in their lives. They had to draw on that. And I did remind them right now, in this very tense world, there are people dying on both sides of whatever political persuasion you are in over there in Israel and Gaza, a lot of those places. So perhaps for all of the victims, of this nonsense, who play this elegy. All day for. It's the next piece. Fanfare by Brian Balmages. Brian had got a trumpet performance at James Madison and then went on to get his master's in Miami in composition. He mostly writes for band music, but then also has some wonderful little pieces for string orchestra and also for orchestra, symphony orchestra, and working string as well. And this is one of them. I love it, and I think they love it more than I do. Yeah, I don't want to, sometimes I forget at the end to thank a lot of people. We have the section coaches who helped me today during the sectionals. Dr. Arnold, Dr. Sass, and Professor Lewis and on base. We have all of the teachers that are here that have brought their students and stayed with them through the day. And I know in the trenches, day to day, every day, they are with them, helping those young musicians progress from their skills. We have the staff here at MPAC who's gracefully landing us this stage for other orchestra, hopefully from now on, because we have, it's a good problem, but we have outgrown Weber. As much as I love Weber, I cannot fit 100 whatever people on stage there, 70 at the most. So it is a good thing that we have outgrown Weber, and thank you for the MPAC staff for letting us invade their space during this honor orchestra. And also there are all of the parents, grandparents and friends, and all of those who encourage those young players here on stage to continue to practice. You take them to their lessons back and forth and all of that. So thank you for that. And of course, I could make a sound, I could wave my hand all I want. There would be no sound without those musicians on stage. And I know this has been a very difficult day, and I hope they've learned a lot. Regardless of however the performance has gone today, they've done a really good job all the way through the day working with me and being very attentive and giving me their best. So thank you very much, students on stage. Stop dropping so they can get to what's better than fair.